Now that we are somewhat more familiar with the interface of AutoCAD, we are going to elaborate on the different ways we can create a new file. By the end of this lesson, we will have also learned how to save a file so we won't lose our work, and naturally, how to open the file we saved. As we have already seen in the previous lesson, once the application opens, on the left side, there is the New button with an arrow next to it. By clicking the New button directly, a new file is automatically created using the template that was last selected. On the contrary, if you click on the arrow next to the New button, a drop-down menu appears letting us choose the template we want to use. If no templates are shown, click on Browse Templates. The window with all the available templates appears. At this point, I shall remind you that among these templates you could use either the AutoCAD or the AutoCAD ISO template, depending on the units you are going to draw in. The main difference between the two is that the AutoCAD ISO template is set up for the metric system, while AutoCAD for the imperial system. So if you are going to draw in metric units, such as meters or millimeters, select this template. And if you are going to draw in inches, select AutoCAD. Once you select the template and click Open, a new file is created. I will close this new file by clicking on the X symbol of the tab Drawing 1. Another way to create a new file is by clicking the New icon in the Quick Access toolbar. The same Select Template window appears. I will select the template I want, and then I will click Open. Another new file has been created, only this time its temporary name is Drawing 2. I will close this file as I previously did without closing the application. Similarly, I could have opened the menu file and selected the option New. The last alternative for creating a new file is to click on the AutoCAD icon in the left corner and select the option New. Once again, the Select Template window opens so you can choose a template. After selecting a template, another new file has been created. After creating a file and starting to work on a project, it's only natural that we would want to save the progress of our work. So it's very important to save our file regularly. The first time we save a file, we need to define a folder inside which it's going to be saved. To do so, all I need to do is click on the Save As icon in the Quick Access toolbar. Or I can open the menu file and select the option Save As instead. Either way, Save Drawing As dialog appears and I can browse through the folders of my computer, find the one I want to save the file, and open it. In the file name field at the bottom of the dialog, I will type the name Test Drawing. Something extremely useful is the Files of Type field. By clicking on the arrow, a list appears which includes older versions of AutoCAD. I can choose to save the file as an older version of AutoCAD so it can be opened by older versions of the application. As for now, I will not change the default option of this field and I will click Save. The file is saved and its name on the tab has also changed from Drawing 3 to Test Drawing. From now on, whatever change I make, no matter how trivial it seems, an asterisk will appear next to the name of the file until I click Save again. To understand this better, I will zoom in slightly. Automatically, the asterisk appeared next to the name of the file. That means that something was changed since the last time I saved the file. To save the progress of my work, I will just click on the icon Save from the Quick Access toolbar, or open the File menu and select Save. Notice that the asterisk has now disappeared. It is going to reappear once I start modifying my drawing again to remind me that I need to save my project. Another detail I would like to mention is that when I first save a file, whether I click Save or Save As makes absolutely no difference. The dialog window Save Drawing As will appear either way, because a path where the file will be saved needs to be defined. We can click on Save As even if we have already saved a file, in case we need to save it in a different location and/or under a different name. So I will click Save As and this time I will select a different folder to save the file. As for the name, I will type Test Drawing 2 and then I will click Save. Now there are two identical yet independent files which I can work on separately. The commands Save and Save As can be also found in the drop-down menu that appears when I click on the AutoCAD icon. From this drop-down menu, the command Save is exactly the same as the one in the Quick Access toolbar. The Save As command, however, has a few more options. I will keep the cursor still for a few moments on the Save As in the drop-down menu and notice that the list with the different options appears. If I choose the option Drawing, then the file will be saved as an AutoCAD file as previously. I can also save this file as a template or as a different format, but I'm not going to elaborate on these options now. I will just close the open file by clicking the X symbol of its tab. As you may have noticed, this is how I can close a file without closing the application. Finally, it's time to open one of the files I created in the previous examples. To open an existing file, we can click on the Open button on the left side of the starting screen. We can also click on the Open icon from the Quick Access toolbar or select Open from the File menu. Alternatively, we can click on the AutoCAD icon and from the drop-down menu, keep the cursor still for a few moments on Open and then choose Drawing from the available options. Whichever way you choose to open a file, the procedure is the same, so feel free to choose whichever you like the best. Personally, I will click on the Open icon from the Quick Access toolbar. The window Select File opens, and I can browse my folders and find the file I wish to open. The same window would have opened no matter where I clicked Open from. I will find the Test Drawing file, select it, and then click Open. After a few moments, the file is open and ready to be further modified.